What is up, guys? It is me, Amelia. If you're new to this channel, my name is Amelia. I am in my third year in a Bachelor of Business majoring in Accounting and Finance at University of Technology, Sydney, in Australia. Welcome to my channel. Because a lot of you guys seem to really like my uni-related content, I thought I would give you another uni video. So today I'm gonna list 10 things I wish I knew before I started uni. So if you wanna ace your uni course, make sure to continue watching this video, because let me tell you, if I would've known these 10 things when I first started uni, my grades in my first year would've looked a lot better. So the first thing I wish I knew before I started uni is that there is a free writing service called Grammarly. And if I would've used this service from the beginning of my uni course, I would have saved so much time checking my grammar and all of that.
So how it works is you upload a document onto the Grammarly site and it eliminates grammar errors and suggests changes that you can make to improve your text. You can also activate the Grammarly browser extension, which checks your writing in Gmail, Facebook, LinkedIn, and wherever else you might write on the internet. There's also a premium version that goes a bit beyond the grammar to help ensure that everything you write is clear, engaging, professional. And the premium version costs money, but a lot of universities provide a free premium subscription to all their students. So definitely check out if your uni offers that.
So the second thing I wish I knew is that you do not have to buy all the books for every single subject in your uni course. I actually found that out like one semester into my degree after I had bought every single book for each and every subject, and I ended up not opening half of the books. Of course, for some subjects you need to buy the books because you might have like mandatory homework and the homework questions are in the books or something like that. And if you really need to buy the book, I suggest first looking for secondhand copies. At a lot of bookshops for student literature, they often have like a secondhand section. So definitely check that out. And if you can't find it there, there's Facebook groups for secondhand books at most unis. And if you can't find it there, I suggest checking out if there's an ebook version of the book you need, because yeah, first of all, it's better for the environment, and second of all, it's a lot cheaper. So the third thing I wish I knew before I started uni is that there is this site called citethisforme.com that makes referencing so much easier and saves you so much freaking time. Referencing is pretty basic. We should all know how to reference, like we're uni students, right? But let's face it, referencing is freaking boring and it can be very tedious. I don't know about you, but for me, when something is boring and tedious, I tend to make mistakes because I tend to be a bit sloppy. I just want to get it over with, you know what I mean? So finding this website that does all the referencing for you has saved my life. Okay, that's a bit dramatic. It has saved me a lot of time. It sounds like I'm sponsored by these websites like Grammarly and Cite This For Me, but I'm really not. I have like 2 subscribers, so. I just genuinely really like these websites, okay? So that's why I'm bringing it up.
So how it works is you just choose the citation style that is used at your university, the source type, and then you just chuck in the links to your references, and Cite This For Me will create a reference list, of course, in alphabetical order. And they also create in-text references that you can just copy and paste into your text. Amazing!
As long as you have good peer-reviewed like academic references, referencing shouldn't be a problem. So losing marks for not referencing correctly is just very like unnecessary. So that's why Cite This For Me is a really good tool to use. It saves you so much time and it's just a lifesaver in university. Another thing I wish I knew before I started uni is that my uni offers so many freaking free resources and services. And this goes for all unis all around the world. Like, make sure to check out what free services and resources your uni is offering, because I swear there's at least one. And my uni, they offer so much free stuff that I had no idea about when I first started. For example, they offer free counseling, they offer free financial advising, they offer free breakfast and dinners 2 times a week. There's so many things like that that you can squeeze out of your uni. if you really need it. Look, unless you're studying in Sweden or something where education is free, don't ask me why I'm studying in Australia for money when I could be studying for free in Sweden as a Swedish citizen, because I don't know. You're paying a shit ton of money for tuition, so you gotta get your money's worth, okay? So make sure you know about all the free services and resources that your uni offers, and make sure to utilize that stuff, okay? So the fifth thing I wish I knew about is that you do not have to do all the readings. At least not in detail. In my first semester, I remember I had one subject where they gave us so many readings, so many pages of readings every single week. I would get so stressed out about this because, first of all, my native language is not English, so that's the first thing. And second of all, I was like, okay, I could be spending all my time reading all of this and getting through all these readings, but then I don't have time to focus on my three other subjects this semester. So I was like, how do I do this? What the hell? Of course, this doesn't go for all degrees and all subjects. Like, sometimes you might have to read everything in detail, but from my experience, you do not have to read everything in detail. What I do is I skim through the text and I get the main points. And if I have homework questions that I have to submit on a weekly basis in relation to my weekly readings, I start off by reading through my homework questions and I just look for the answers in the text. I don't even start off by reading. I just look for the answers. I skim through the whole text and I look for the answers. And if it's an online reading, I simply just click Command F and I search for the words in the question in the text. And if you're lucky, you'll just find the answer right there by doing that. The homework questions will most of the time cover the main points anyways, so it's not like you will learn less by using the strategy. The sixth thing I wish I knew before I started uni is that all the high achievers are in the front of the classroom. Whenever it's time to form groups for a group assignment or something, make sure you sit in the front of the classroom if you want to get into a good group. While we're on the group work topic, if you're noticing that one of your group members is not contributing as much as they should, make sure to snitch on that bitch as early as possible. You are not studying your ass off and paying a bunch of tuition to do someone else's work, okay? If you notify your lecturer, your tutor, your subject coordinator early enough, you might be able to swap groups or kick that person out. And if it's too far into the semester to do any drastic changes like that, you should still tell your subject coordinator, your lecturer, your tutor, or whatever, because that person that's not contributing can still get like a grade deduction, and they should. Because your time is precious, okay? Your time is precious. Your time is not worth less than anyone else's time. So you should not be doing work for someone else that's not contributing. The slackers should not be given the same grade as you, okay? You are beautiful, you are smart, know your worth, okay? Okay, let's move on to the seventh thing I wish I knew before I started uni. And this might not work for everyone, but it has worked for me. Whenever you have an exam, make sure to start off by solving the questions that are worth the most marks. This might be really obvious for most people, but in my first semester, I did not think about this little strategy, and let me tell you, I would have gotten a lot better grades in my first semester if I would have done my final exams like this. At my uni, we usually get like 10 minutes of reading time before we can start writing the exam. I like to take that time to skim through all the questions of the final exam and just come up with a strategy for the exam. Let's say, for example, I'm doing a final exam where the first part of the exam is made up of 20 multiple choice questions worth a total of 20 marks, and then the second part of the exam is made up of 4 larger, more difficult problem-solving questions worth 20 marks each, totaling up to 80 marks. I will start off by doing the questions in the second half of the exam first and then do the multiple choice questions last. Because if worst case scenario, I do not have enough time to finish all the questions, at least I focused on solving the questions with a higher weighting rather than the questions worth less, if you know what I mean. Basically, I suggest starting off with the harder questions and then doing the easier questions last because they tend to be worth less marks. Okay, number 8. I wish I knew about all the scholarships I could have freaking applied for before I started uni. Applying for scholarships was in the back of my mind, but I just thought that I would never be able to get a scholarship because I didn't have like the best grades in high school. Like, I was very like sick of school when I went to high school. And I think because a lot of people think this way, that I will never get one, so why would I even apply? it's a lot easier to get a scholarship than you think. Don't get me wrong, of course it's hard to get scholarships, like they don't just give out free money to anyone, like you have to put in a lot of hard work into your scholarship applications and stuff like that, and they can be really lengthy and tedious to do. I actually went to see a financial advisor at my uni, and she actually said that they do not receive as many scholarship applications as you would think, and her theory was the same, like people don't think that they can receive them because they don't have good enough grades or something, but because people think this way, it ends up being easier than you would think to get a scholarship because not that many people apply, if that makes sense. So before you start uni, make sure that you're applying to all of the scholarships that you can possibly apply for, okay? So the ninth thing I wish I knew about before I started uni is that internships can be counted towards your degree. You can get credits for them. So this doesn't apply for all degrees, but at most universities, you can do an internship as a part of your major or as an elective. I didn't know about this when I first started my uni course, so I ended up doing an unpaid internship for 2 months. And once I found out about I could have the internship counted towards my degree, it was already too late to enroll in the subject and get credits for it. So definitely check out if your uni offers an internship subject like this, because if you're doing an unpaid internship, you might as well make it count towards your degree. I don't know. I wish I would have done that. Hey guys, so the last thing I wish I knew before I started uni is that you can get $1 coffees at 7-Eleven. At least in Australia. I don't know how it works anywhere else, but I'm sure they're pretty cheap all around the world. I did not know about this in my first semester at uni, so I spent so much money on coffee because I'm a big coffee drinker, and especially when I'm studying and I'm staying up late studying at the library. If you're like me, you're not a coffee snob, you're into long blacks, and you're on a student budget, 7-Eleven coffees, they do the job, okay? But make sure that you bring your own keep cup because we're trying to save the planet over here, okay? So get a keep cup and get those $1 coffees, baby. This is not a 7-Eleven coffee, I brew this at home. So I try to obviously brew coffee at home and bring it to school, but if I need coffee while I'm at school, I go to 7-Eleven, okay? Because they have the cheapest coffee. Okay guys, that is it for today's video. I hope that it was somewhat helpful. Give this video a like if you thought it was helpful, and also leave a comment down below with some video suggestions or questions that you might have about university or UTS or being a student in Australia. And don't forget to press the little notifications button so you get notified whenever I post new videos. I'm trying to become more consistent with posting, so please bear with me. I'm trying over here. Bye!